and a great motivational speaker, Dr. Karanveer Singh, to ITIT. Please give him a round of applause. Today is a very auspicious day. Today is also Ram Navami. We all celebrate here in North India in a very, very big way. It's also on the eve of Durga Puja, which is also done in a very big way in Assam and West Bengal. Tomorrow, of course, you have your holiday with Dashera, then you have Sunday, and then you have Gandhi Jayanti. So congratulations to all of you. You have three holidays coming up. So before we go for these holidays, I wanted that we communicate with you the important aspects of life and life management skills. And that's why today I have requested sir to come from Mumbai and share his views, his research, what he has done in his PhD, and what he has learned by traveling across the world with all of you boys and girls. So sir, with these words.
So my name is Karanveer. So like Aman stated, so what we're going to talk about is that I'm sure in the journey of studying various things, we talk about personality, we talk about people, we talk about various aspects which can take you to a different height in your career. Yes or no?
Yes.
Do you want me to speak English? English?
English?
English?
Yes.
All right.
So let's take you.
Am I audible to you?
No, sir.
No?
So, yeah. Am I audible now?
Yes.
So, what we're going to do is, there are a few things which is very important when we say we're going to talk about growing forward in life. So, when I was doing my PhD, so I happened to tap into a topic, we call it relationship, and I met hundreds of people to do my research to figure it out that how relationships are actually helping people to be their better version, right? So when I'm saying relationship, I'm not only referring to boyfriends and girlfriends, right? So I'm referring to your family, I'm referring to your friends, I'm referring to your colleagues, I'm referring to your classmates, and I'm referring to everybody in your ecosystem when I'm saying friends. Or relationship. So these relationships help you to grow in your life. We're going to talk about how we do that. So keeping that in the background, so I came up with an idea and I call it a PIQ. So when I say PIQ, it means the personal impact quotient. Right? It's very easy. Have you heard that some people are very charismatic? Yes or no?
Yes.
You know, you meet those people, you get impressed, you meet those people, you want to hear them, you want to talk to them for a longer time, and you want to interact with them. If you keep talking, you don't get bored because they have some kind of a charisma. Right? So when we say what exactly is a charisma, it's the same thing we call it a personal impact quotient, which is a combination of three elements. So when I say what exactly are three elements, the next slide will come in, right? How do you go ahead and create that impression on somebody? You know, how do you create that impression which lasts longer? And when anybody meets you, it's take 30 seconds. 30 seconds to create a judgment about you that are you a good person or not a good person? 30 seconds. And in those 30 seconds, people make 32 observations about you. 32 observations in 30 seconds. आप सोच के देखो उसने पूरी laundry list print की है 30 seconds में कि आप कौन हो. They go up to the level even saying that is this person trustworthy or not? Have you noticed that? You meet somebody, you saw them say hi and hello, and something in your head you say this person is not trustworthy. How the hell are you going to figure it out in 30 seconds? How do you know? You haven't even spoken to that person. You haven't even exchanged anything. And you decided this person is not a trustworthy, which is a big thing. Which we're going to talk about today. And how exactly PIQ helps you. So, there are three major components to it when we say, you
forward.
There are three components to it. We say invest, influence, and impact.
Have you ever impressed anyone? Or have you heard that somebody said that I'm really impressed by it?
Yes.
Yes? Do you know why they said that? That you don't know. Right? But every one of us got this idea that I'm really impressed by you. Right? How do you actually impress me? You never decoded that, you never gone back and asked this question, but what made you get impressed by me? And definitely influence and impact is a little on the higher side. When we put these three elements together, the personality is called charismatic personality. Right? What exactly happened in this? The first interaction is when you meet somebody new, when you meet somebody first time, we all have certain memories in our head of certain type of people. आपको बहुत सारे लोग मिले पास्ट में, आपने उनके साथ बहुत सारे एक्सपीरियंसेस रहे, वो मेमोरीज आपके दिमाग में स्टोर रहती हैं। जब भी आप किसी नए आदमी को मिलते हो, उन मेमोरीज के चश्मे के थ्रू आप उन लोगों को देखते हो। अगर उस आदमी की शक्ल किसी ऐसे आदमी से मैच कर गई 40% से ज्यादा जिसने आपको कभी कहीं ट्रबल किया होगा, यू विल नॉट लाइक दिस पर्सन, राइट? और जो आपके दिमाग में आइडियल पिक्चर है कि आपका पार्टनर, आपका दोस्त कैसा होना चाहिए, अगर वो इमेज 60% उससे मैच कर गई, तो यू विल फॉल इन लव विद दैट पर्सन। सो आई टेल यू हाउ लव हैपेंस, राइट? सो व्हेन एवरीबॉडी ग्रोज फ्रॉम द एज ऑफ 8 टू द एज ऑफ 18, इन 10 सालों में आप बहुत सारे मैगजीन्स देखते हो, बहुत सारी मूवीज देखते हो, टीवी शोज देखते हो, यू गो थ्रू लॉट ऑफ दोस थिंग्स. And by looking at those houses, those dresses, those people, their faces, you create a library in your head. It's not library, I would say a kind of a museum, an art gallery, jisme ek tasveer hai, which is of your perfect partner. One picture is of your perfect car you wanted to have. One picture, the perfect house you wanted to have. One picture, possibly the perfect career you want to have. इस एग्जीबिशन के साथ यू आर मूविंग अराउंड इन द सोसाइटी, राइट? यू गो टू कॉलेज, यू अटेंड फैमिली फंक्शंस, यू गो टू वेरियस प्लेसेस. नाउ द मोमेंट यू सॉ दैट कार ऑन द रोड, व्हिच इज 60%+ रिजेम्बलेंस ऑफ द कार इन योर हेड, योर हेड टर्न एंड यू लुक एट दैट कार. व्हेन यू सी द हाउस व्हिच इज 60%+ रिजेम्बलेंस ऑफ द हाउस इन योर हेड टर्न्स. The same way when you see a girl or a boy who's a 60% resemblance of the mental picture, you smile. आपको लगता है वो मिल गई, right? Your head turns 45 degree Celsius temperature, आपको गर्मी नहीं लगती है. पर शाहरुख खान वाला वो music चलता है, you know, and you feel nothing. We call it a rush of oxytocin. This is an hormone released in your head. So I cannot convert a love into a science, but that's okay. So this is what happened. It's a 60% resemblance. Imagine if it is an 80% resemblance, what you would do? You will go crazy. You will not be able to sleep that you wanted to see that person again. Now there are two possibilities. You saw this girl or a boy, and there is a possibility you will meet this person again in your college, in your social circle or something like that. And there is a possibility you might not see this person. So let's take a possibility one where you get a chance to see this person. What happened? Human brain is one of the amazing things, and it functions beyond your comprehension. Really, really beyond your comprehension. So brain would play a trick. We call it altered personality. So you will go to the friend circle of that girl or the boy and try figuring out that what kind of a guy or girl this guy likes. Right? The moment you have those key points that this guy likes, this kind of a hairstyle, this kind of eating habit, this kind of things and that, you start making those changes in your personality unknowingly. You're not taking this like really, really, it's happening in a very automated mode. And after, when you believe that you're really out there, you present yourself to that girl. Correct? Now there is a reality. The girl also have a mental image, and that mental image strikes with the image first, the visuals first, but you are not even close to the visual that girl have in her head. But the qualities you have presented are at par with her checklist. You got it? Qualities at par, but shakal utni achhi nahi hai. Jo uske dimag mein shakal thi, aap uska 10% bhi nahi. But the brain is a very smart machine. It knows that the physical reality can change, but the value system will never change. Right? So the brain would reshuffle the priorities and the girl would say, let's give it a try. So let's give it a try. She would be ready to have a coffee with you. She would be ready to walk a few steps with you. And when you get this opportunity, then you further go crazy. Then you do anything damn possible on this earth to allure this girl or boy. You know, people get up in the morning and send the first message, good morning, baby. Have you seen people like that? They send you a message. So, what are you wearing today? Have you had your lunch? Missing you? Have you seen frequent messages start coming? And they don't miss it. And you reply with a single word, you reply with a two-liner, nobody cares. They would continue to put their dedicated effort because the brain wanted to have that. Because it's very difficult to get the reality of your mental image. So in psychology, we call this an altered personality. Now the beauty of this science is, if you're a boy, you can hold this altered personality for 45 days. But if you're a girl, then you can hold this altered personality for 6 months. Girls have more patience, right? And in that case, good, appreciate yourself for that. So, look, what happened after 45 days? I'm taking a boy's case. So what happened? 45 days, this guy says that, you know what? I only message. If I message, she replies. If I call, she goes. She never calls back. She never replies. And after 45, this reality just happened. Come. And then he would come and say that, you know, I did this for you, I did that for you, I did this for you, you never did anything. You know what answer you get? Did I tell you to do it? Now what happened, and this is quite a harsh reality check. I never said, right? So the altered personality get crashed and the guy started to behave the way he was actually. Then the girl says, "Tum badal gaye." Have you heard this statement? So she doesn't know ki badla nahi hai, to original version. What you were experiencing from last month and a half, that was the changed version. So research says that 87.3% relationship breaks down at this level. Right? And still, all 13% people are able to talk through it and able to create the reality. That's how brain functions. Right? It's very interesting how people fall in love, how people build relationships. And this is the same formula. You can change a little bit and you can create that impact everywhere. How do you figure out? But what happened? We are so full of crap in our head. We are so full of ourselves, we don't even look at the reality outside. To understand somebody, that what kind of a person she is, how much time it should take? 2 minutes. I can read left-right center that what kind of personality she is, and all of you can do that. There's no rocket science. There's only one quality you need to have, that you need to leave yourself aside and look at her in a very, very non-judgmental space. You don't judge her that she is like that, which means she can be like that. You can't do that. Because that's your memory plane. When you start reading people, you start understanding people, you build better relationship. So to whom you call love, at your level, is technically not a love. So it's a rush of oxytocin. It's an illusion of brain. And how do you know this is a real illusion of brain? And it's not even real love? You don't know, right? There are 4 things. You will figure it immediately. It's not love. When people are connected at a relationship level, their way of conversation change. You know what? How they talk? We. The conversation is a we center. We did this. We went to that place. We shared this. We watched movie. We did this. Second, they share a lot. Right? They share everything. They don't just share the kind of food you like, they don't just share the kind of color you like, they share everything, they share the strength, they share weaknesses. And the third thing what happens is, they involve you in their plans. They involve you in the plan because they believe there's going to be a future. They start making plans together. Right? And they inspire each other. So when these four things started to happen with somebody, then you are really in a relationship. If nothing is happening, any of one thing is missing, so I would call that relation is a bullshit. Because it's a very important emotion. So it's a highly misunderstood. When we say, I'm in love, I love this question, why do you love this person? There's another way to figure out, is it real love or not? The moment people are able to answer this question, okay, I love you, perfect, why do you love you? The moment they answer you, then this is not love, then it's a transaction. Have you heard? Why do you love me? I love you because I feel comfortable around you. Have you heard this kind of statement? You make me feel good, right? When I'm sitting next to you, you know, I feel very relaxed. I feel safe. From whom? I don't know. The moment tomorrow these feelings, life changes, right? Tomorrow if these feelings are no longer there, the heart will also die. So when people are, that's my research, I met around 96 people while interacting about writing a paper on relationship. This was the interesting finding I figured out. When people have a reason for love, then this love is a transaction. Why I'm sharing all this with you. At this age where the energy should be focused on creating a wonderful future, sometimes these things take us to a different track where we are not really focusing where we're supposed to focus. At your age, if somebody really understands what love is, what relationship is, and I'll tell you another thing. Love and relationships are two different things. People can be in love and not in a relationship. People can be in a relationship, not in love. So if at your age, you are clear with these thoughts, you know, you would have so much energy available to create a wonderful future. Otherwise, those WhatsApp messages, maybe lunch again, maybe didn't reply, maybe sleep. Or maybe having lunch with somebody else, the another baby. Right? And you keep looking at the screen. Happens to you? Why is she not replying? It's a double tick, it's blue. I haven't got the message yet. So much goes into it. But if you're able to objectively see that what is happening, you have so much energy available to you. Falling in love is a beautiful thing. You know why they call it falling in love? Anybody? Falling. Why they call falling? Why can't say rising in love? Right? It's a very interesting thing. Why they say falling in love? Falling means somebody going to fit into your life, right? To make sure that somebody else fit into your life, you need to make some space available for them. Yes or no? Yes. If someone is coming into your life, then you have to make a place for it. So that place normally is an emotional space. Right? आपको उसको अपनी जिंदगी में जगह देनी पड़ेगी. कुछ लोग उस इमोशनल स्पेस को दोस्तों से भर के रखते हैं. सो देन यू गेट अ कंप्लेंट कि तू दोस्तों के साथ ही रहती है, यू डोंट हैव अ टाइम फॉर मी. कुछ लोग उस स्पेस को अपने पुराने एक्स बॉयफ्रेंड और गर्लफ्रेंड से भर के रखते हैं. हैव यू सीन दोस काइंड ऑफ पीपल? राइट? और कुछ लोग इतने अमेजिंग होते हैं कि दे कांट टेक अ रिजेक्शन ऑफ देयर पार्टनर लीविंग देम. वो जब छोड़ के चले जाते हैं फिर उनके दोस्त बन जाते हैं. नाउ ही इज अ बेस्ट फ्रेंड. Have you seen those kind of people? Because he rejected me, or she rejected me. I can't take that. So, dost banake rehte isi bahane phook mein to rahe gaye. And ego polish hoti rehti. But you're not letting that space go. How are you going to create a relationship? And some people fill ego in that space. Have you seen people that continue to competition with their friends, with their family, with their brothers, with their loved ones? The competition. So they say falling in love because you need to make some space at an emotional level that somebody else can fit in. So that's why I say fall in love. So there's no other reason they fall in love. Right? So the idea to share this is that getting at this age, you're young. Your average is, I believe, 20, 21? Yes. Or might be 22, right? This is the perfect age when you get misled by the idea of love. Right? How do you guys even fall in love? Somebody looked at you and smiled. Or aap na Punjab, I don't know how many Punjabis are over here. Yet somebody turns twice toward koi dusre wale ko bolte hai tumne bhabhi dekhi tumne. So it's amazing over here. Somebody looked at you. And then, do you not know bhabhi hai tumhari? Tab bhabhi ban gayi. Because usne pehle meri taraf dekha to meri bhabhi hogi. It's a crazy arrangement, but imagine you have this space available. Focus on something more amazing, something more creative. So let's see, how do we impress people? So this was one topic. So to impress somebody, imagine you go for an interview, right? Or let's take your example. You meet somebody, you're really impressed by that person. Would you ask interrogative, threatening question to that person? Right? You're impressed. You really like that person. You got like, wow. Will you ask threatening question? No. You will never ask. You're otherwise in the gaga feeling that, wow, this is really good. So there are six elements you can use to impress people. The first is fight versus flight. So basically what happens when you don't like somebody, you like to run away from them. Have you seen, you meet somebody first time. They haven't done anything good or bad to you, but you don't like that person. Have you seen that happening to you? All of us go through that feeling. You don't even know that person, but somehow you don't like. And then either you fight with them, or you fight, sarcasm. Then you will crack joke on that person's dressing style, the way he is or she is. Then you fight, that's called fighting. Or you run away. You said, I don't want to talk to this person. So this is the one thing, when you want to impress somebody, you need to hold your ground. You don't want to run away. Even if you like that person, you don't like that person, you can create that opportunity to build an amazing affinity. The second is a sensory language. What is sensory language? It is slightly different than the body language. You pay close look at somebody's face. Are they interested in you or they're not interested in you? You will figure out by looking at their face. You know how? Human beings have a maximum attention span of 6 minutes. Right? Maximum attention span is 6 minutes. After 6 minutes, the mind wanders. And I'm talking about a healthy human being. For somebody who's already screwed up in head, you can cut it down to 3 minutes. So I say, let's, everybody screwed up at some level today, so let's take an average of 4 minutes. So today the attention span of people is 4 minutes. That's why all these babas, have you heard any satsang and all those things? All these, lot of spiritual babas nowadays, for 5-6 minutes, you know, bolenge, bolo Bhagwan Shri Ramachandra ki jai! Everybody says that in the air. They know that, they have to do it every 5-6 minutes. कुछ लोगों ने कीर्तन वाले बिठाए होते हैं, so हर 5-6 मिनट बाद वो भजन गाना शुरू करते हैं, right? I've seen somebody in Ahmedabad, he's another fabulous speaker, you know, he talks like, ah, ये हुआ वो है, ah, you know, हर 5 मिनट में shouts back, and everybody back. These are fabulous public speakers. They know that the people sitting out there, their attention span is hardly 4-5 minutes. So they, this is the tactics. So when we say sensory language, if you hold somebody's gaze toward you for more than 5 minutes, you rock and roll. You rock and roll. If you hold somebody's attention for 4 bloody minutes, you would be the best person in the world. And how do you do that? You can't do that just by talking. Lots of people, you know, when I go to college, they say I have a confidence issue. What will happen? कि अगर मैं स्टेज पे आया और कुछ बोलने के लिए और मुझे भूल गया तो दिस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टू इट नेसेसरी यू कैन बी लव विद योरसेल्फ यू नो हाउ डू यू लव विद इट व्हेन यू स्टार्ट रिस्पेक्टिंग योरसेल्फ एंड यू स्टार्ट डूइंग फॉर योर पर्सनल ग्रोथ एवरी डे दोस आर द एलिमेंट ऑफ पर्सनल लव सो लव नीड नॉट टू हैव टू पीपल इन बट अ रिलेशनशिप डेफिनेटली नीड टू राइट इट्स अ कंपेनशिप यू कैन बी इन अ रिलेशनशिप where you share a coffee pot. You can be in a relationship where you share a party pot. You can be in a relationship where you just share a study partner.
Yes.
So relationship can have trust, can have comfort, not necessarily have love. So love is a very different emotion. So that's how it is.